Everyone, welcome back to Spectrum classes. Today in this video we are going to prepare sodium thiosulfate solution as well as its standardization with the help of potassium dichromate. So here I am going to prepare the sodium thiosulfate solution. For that I have taken 2.48 grams of sodium thiosulfate. Now I am preparing the solution, so the weight amount you have to transfer to the measuring flask. Now rinse your funnel properly and shake it well to dissolve the sodium thiosulfate into the distilled water. And now once it is dissolved, you make up the solution up to the mark which is given over there, and the solution is 100 ml. The calculation which we have done is for 100 ml. So this is how we can prepare sodium thiosulfate solution. Here it is as weighed and calculated n by 10 sodium thiosulfate, and this sodium thiosulfate is pentahydrated. Now we are going to prepare potassium dichromate solution, and for that purpose I have taken 0.49 grams of potassium dichromate. Now I transferred it again in the same way, and now I am going to rinse this funnel properly and thoroughly. Now I am going to dissolve this potassium dichromate. So you see it is not completely dissolved, so you have to dissolve it first. Once it is dissolved, you make up the solution up to the mark, and this solution is 100 ml. After making it up to the mark, you shake it well before use. Now we are going to rinse the glassware, because we are standardizing, so every glassware should be washed thoroughly and it is rinsed before using. So in the burette I am going to fill the sodium thiosulfate solution, so I am rinsing it with the help of sodium thiosulfate solution. Now I fill it after rinsing 2-3 times. You take little more amount in the burette just to fill this nozzle. Now I am going to rinse conical flask also with the potassium dichromate, as I am going to take potassium dichromate in the conical flask. And now I am going to transfer 25 ml of potassium dichromate in the conical flask, and this potassium dichromate solution is of n by 10 concentration. Initial reading of the burette is 0. We are going to add this potassium dichromate solution in the conical flask. Now I am going to add potassium iodide to this 0.5 grams to the conical flask, and now I am shaking it. You see no color change is visible. Now I am going to add 1 ml of concentrated HCl solution to this conical flask, and you see the color iodine is liberated. Now lid this conical flask with the help of a petri dish. I am showing you the color, but before doing the titration you keep it with the wrapped brown paper just to avoid the exposure of this conical flask from the direct sunlight, because that can oxidize this iodine. Now titrating it against the sodium thiosulfate solution, and we first do this titration until this dark brown color get it painted. Now we are going to add starch solution to this, 2-3 drops. I am adding 3-4 drops actually. So you see the color of starch iodine complex. Now we are again titrating it, and on titration you see the color disappears. This I am shaking it just to ensure that the iodine is titrated, and see later on you will see this type of color. So you may get confused, titration is completed or not. Actually this is because of the chromium 3 plus ions. Now take the final reading of the burette, which is about 25 ml. Now calculate the concentration. Now coming to the observation table, here in observation table I have kept the volume taken for K2Cr2O7 is 25 ml, which is taken in the conical flask. Initial reading of the burette is 0 and final reading of the burette is 25 ml. So on subtracting this final to initial, we get 25 ml of sodium thiosulfate is consumed. Now calculation using the normality equation. So N1 V1 is equal to N2 V2. Here this side I have chosen K2Cr2O7 and on this side I have chosen sodium thiosulfate. On putting the values of these N1 V1 normality and volume on each sides, so N1 is N by 10 for K2Cr2O7, which I have prepared by calculation, and since it is a primary standard, so it is supposed that the weight we have taken is exactly get the same normal solution. And against this 25 ml of N by 10 K2Cr2O7, 25 ml of sodium thiosulfate is consumed. Now calculating the normality of sodium thiosulfate, which we have prepared, this will be cancelled out by this. So normality of sodium thiosulfate is N by 10, which we prepared by weighing. This is the result. Now coming to the preparation of N by 80 hyposolution. So this N by 80 hyposolution will be prepared by dilution method, and here we are again using this normality equation. So I want to prepare N by 80 sodium thiosulfate solution and in 100 ml. So whatever volume you want to prepare, you can put that volume here. This equal to stock solution. So stock solution is N by 10 now, which we have standardized. Now volume of this standardized hyposolution taken to prepare this solution in 100 ml. So on calculation I will get that 12.5 ml of hyposolution of N by 10 normality is taken in 100 ml to prepare N by 80 hyposolution by this dilution method.
So we come to know that the sodium thiosulfate solution which we have prepared by weighing is about N by 10 normality. So we are going to prepare N by 80 solution by dilution method. So for that purpose I am going to take 12.5 ml of sodium thiosulfate, which is already filled in the burette, to this measuring flask. On adding 12.5 ml of N by 10 sodium thiosulfate solution to this measuring flask, I will stop this and you see the reading. So after calculation I have done this, and this is 12.5 ml in this measuring flask. Now I am going to make up the solution up to the mark by distilled water. This measuring flask is of 100 ml. So this is how we can prepare N by 80 sodium thiosulfate solution by dilution method from the standardized N by 10 sodium thiosulfate solution. If you find this video useful, please like, share and subscribe. Thank you all. Thanks for watching.